Hey, 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 Capricorn, this is your sacred scribe here. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is going to be a reading for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Jupiter, and North Node. This won't resonate with everybody, of course, but hopefully it will with you. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe right down below there, Capricorn, if you would, before you leave. I do appreciate it. And thank you so much for all of your likes, shares, and subscriptions. If you guys are interested in a personal reading, that way this is more specific to you and your questions and your needs. Information can be found in the description box below. Don't forget to comment as well. Let me know if this resonates. I want to hear from you guys, and hit that notification bell. That way you get notified whenever I upload a video or go live. All right, Cappies, let's see what's up for you guys. How you guys doing today? Okay, so we have the Magician. Oh, what are we manifesting, Capricorn? What's a coming for Cappies? Ooh, Six of Swords. Some of you Capricorns could be moving. You manifesting a move? If you are moving, I feel like you may meet somebody. Move. You also are, I feel like you're searching for inner peace here. It's like you're on your way. You're on the journey to peace. That's what I'm feeling. The World. Yeah, you're about to start a brand spanking new beginning. Two Wands, and you're pretty excited about it. You're pretty optimistic about this. I like this. And here we have a moving card again, so definitely moving. Tell me about the Magician, this manifester here. Ace of Swords. So there's some truth and clarity that you're coming to. Or you may be receiving truth and clarity from somebody. Let's see, what's this truth and clarity? The Sun. What is making you happy? And again, my right ear is ringing. It was ringing on the last reading too. Concentrate on your masculine energy. There may be some sort of action that needs to be taken. The Nine of Swords. Okay, so something's making you anxious and fearful. Possibly, I don't know, you've got a lot of new coming, and I feel like you're becoming clear on what your happiness means to you, what makes you happy with this Sun card. I mean, that's the ultimate happiness here. So tell me about the Six of Swords, just moving on to peace here. The Knave of Chalices. Okay, so you could have an apology coming to you with the Knave of Chalices, or you could be giving an apology. Let's see what this is. The Moon. Yeah, I feel like it's coming towards you, and you can't see this. You won't see this coming. Now, with the Moon in this deck, this is a twin flame card in this deck for me. If you can see this, there's two couples there, and it's mirror images of the same couple. So it's like something's, this apology could be a love offer as well. You don't see coming. Wow, that flew out. The Queen of Wands. So this could be from a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sag, or it just could be somebody with those traits. Now, the Queen of Wands is sexy, confident, good looking, very sexual, and a magical manifester. She or he knows definitely how to manifest. Very alluring, okay? So this is something that you don't see yet. So let's see what the Two of Wands is. We have the Stars. You're making wishes. And the Three of Chalices. So that talks about a reunion, or this could be just dating. Oops. Okay. What is this Three of Chalices here for Capricorn? What's this Three of Chalices here? The Knight of Swords. Fast communication. This could be with somebody from the past. What is this Knight of Swords? The King of Swords. Could be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius here. So some sort of communication is coming from somebody from the past. Now, this could be somebody that you've healed over or that you're wishing for, or both. Who is this King of Swords to Capricorn? Seven of Wands. So with the Seven of Wands, I feel it's like I feel like a fight. Or it could be you're standing up for yourself with the Seven of Wands here. There's almost a sense of, they're saying disbelief. That's interesting. Disbelief in what? Disbelief in, all right, now I gotta clarify this again. Disbelief in what? What are you not believing? The Eight of Wands. Okay, so whoever this is, they could be expressing passion to you, right? Communicating to you how they feel. But for some reason, you're not quite believing it. This passion that they're expressing. Why aren't you believing it? Why isn't Capricorn believing this? Why isn't Capricorn believing this? Why do they find it hard to believe? Seven of Pentacles. I feel like this may be a matter of trust and there's patience that's needed with the Seven of Pentacles. Like, if this person is expressing this passion to you, or whatever that they're communicating, I do feel like it's love, it's passion. Then there's something about it that you have this disbelief, distrust in. So I feel like you're not going to turn this away, but you're going to take this slow. And I feel like because it's a wish over here. So tell me about the world. The High Priestess. And the Ten of Wands. So there's something that, Now the High Priestess is the Keeper of Secrets, also a Twin Flame card of mine. What is the High Priestess? The Four of Wands, Twin Flame. So there's something that's hidden. It could be a relationship here. It could be this relationship. Because there's a lot of work that's going to be put into it. So maybe nothing's being said about this because, you know, the High Priestess knows how to manifest, right? And one of the rules of manifestation is if you want something to manifest, don't say anything. Not until it gets rolling and gets wheels, right? It's easier to stop a boulder at the top of a mountain than it is in the middle. You know what I'm saying? And people like to insert their energy into circumstances, right? And you don't need that. So the Ace of Wands here, yeah. So this is a new beginning in passion and love, but it's going to be kept secret for a bit. All right, so what is your advice here? Wow. What is your advice here? The Two of Swords. Do not block off your heart chakra. Okay? And also they're saying listen to your intuition. Nine of Wands. Don't give up. That's what I'm getting with that. That is the Wounded Warrior, right? Could have to do with this over here, this distrust, this disbelief. And they're saying don't give up and open up your heart chakra here. The Wheel is at the bottom of the deck, which is destiny and fate stepping in here. Change. And you get a lot of change coming. I do feel a move. Okay, so what is your advice for Capricorn here? Advice for Capricorn? Let go. What, if anything, can be done to let go of what is standing in your way? And that's the number 853. Let me get you one more. So what, if anything, can be done to let go of what is standing in your way? Obstacles. Do not dwell on how you are going to surmount obstacles presently in your way. That's so funny. So don't dwell on it, because then you get into that Eight of Swords energy, Capricorn, where it just, you know, nothing gets solved because you just keep going over and over and over and over in your mind about these obstacles. And, you know, it's just try to find, for every problem, there is a solution. That's what we need to be searching for, is the solution, not the problem. Focusing on the problem isn't getting anybody anywhere, doesn't get anybody anywhere, right? All right, Capricorn, I hope this resonated. Please drop a like below, share and subscribe if you already haven't, if you're interested in a personal reading. That way this is more specific to you and your questions and your needs. Information can be found in the description box below. Don't forget to comment as well. Let me know if this resonates. I want to hear from you guys, and hit that notification bell. That way you get notified whenever I upload a video or go live. Have a fabulous day, Cappies, and I will catch you guys on the flip side on the dailies. Namaste.